17 News at 10. It is a violent night in St. Louis, just a couple hours after the St. Louis grand jury chose not to indict the Ferguson police officer Darren Wilson in the shooting death of 18-year-old Michael Brown.
St. Louis County Prosecutor Robert McCullough made the grand jury's announcement at about 8:20 this evening. This right here is a live look at the Walgreens in Ferguson. We are getting reports that parts of the building are on fire.
Some people have actually tweeted pictures of the inside of the building. You could see flames visible. We can see the smoke from this aerial from outside now.
And protests immediately turned violent after the announcement. A crowd began throwing things at police, including a Molotov cocktail, and barricades are also being knocked down.
Police in riot gear are trying to stand their ground, and smoke has been developed as they try to break up crowds using those incendiary devices. Media outlets in St. Louis are also reporting on looting on South Florissant, just north of the police department there. And we're finding out, too, that I-44 is closed in both directions at Grand. So they're protesting on the interstate from what we're hearing.
Yeah, and Prosecutor McCullough says the grand jury found no probable cause, we know this, to charge the officer. And Michael Brown's family actually released a statement as well following the decision, saying, quote, "While we are disappointed that the killer of our child will not face the consequence of his actions, while we wait and understand that many others share our pain, we ask that you channel your frustration in ways that will make a positive change. We need to work together to fix the system that allowed this to happen," unquote. The family went on to ask the public to join their campaign to ensure every police officer in the nation is required to wear a body camera.
President Obama also spoke to the nation less than an hour ago. He says demonstrators have to accept the grand jury's decision, no matter how they feel about it.
He joins the Brown family in calling for peaceful protests. And here's what he had to say on our newscast.
We should be honoring their wishes. I also appeal to the law enforcement officials in Ferguson and the region to show care and restraint in managing peaceful protests that may occur.
And as we've reported, the Justice Department is holding its own civil rights investigation that could result in federal charges. In the last 15 minutes, we've also learned members of the NAACP will start a march from Ferguson to Jefferson City, and that will start this Saturday.
And Officer Wilson's defense team also released a statement tonight. The team says Wilson had to make a split-second decision, difficult decision. The statement went on to say, quote, "Officer Wilson would like to thank those who have stood by his side throughout the process. This continued support is greatly appreciated by Officer Wilson and his family." We have complete team coverage tonight with crews in Clayton and here in Mid-Missouri. Our crews are standing by in Jefferson City and Columbia.
But first, let's go out to ABC 17's Lucas Geisler, who is in St. Louis. He's been there since Friday, and he's joining us now from Clayton outside of the St. Louis County Justice Center. And Lucas, tell us what's happening right now.
Up until the last 30 seconds, Marissa and Joey, it has been very quiet here in Clayton, where Prosecutor Bob McCullough made that announcement earlier about 8:20 tonight, saying that they would not hand up an indictment against Officer Darren Wilson. We just saw about 30 seconds ago about a little more than a dozen law enforcement cars go heading through Clayton right now, many of them with the Missouri State Highway Patrol, but it looked like there were different agencies involved in that. We don't know where they were heading, though. That's just what we saw in the last 30 seconds. Other than that, though, has been very quiet here in Clayton, where they made that announcement earlier tonight. Prosecutor McCullough saying that now that this criminal investigation, at least at the local level, is finished, there would be many, he would release a 1,000-page report that went into the investigation of the shooting death of 18-year-old Michael Brown on August 9th. We do know a few of the details that had been unconfirmed up until this point, including the number of shots that Officer Wilson fired that afternoon, which is 12, and how close and where Michael Brown's body was in relation to Officer Wilson's SUV. At the 2 days after the day after the shooting, we had heard police sources said that his body was found about 35 feet. His body was 35 feet from the SUV. We now heard today that it was about 150 feet from the SUV. That and many more details will be in that 1,000-page report now that the local criminal investigation has ended. However, Attorney General Eric Holder says that the federal criminal investigation is still ongoing at this point, and that has always been independent from the local investigation. I spoke to State Senator Jamila Nasheed in the parking lot right after that grand jury decision was announced. She says that she will later support legislation that would take local prosecutors off of cases that have officer-involved shootings and would appoint a special prosecutor to the case, a call that many critics to the situation had called for since the beginning. Reporting live here in Clayton, Missouri, Lucas Geisler, ABC 17 News.
Lucas, thank you. While you were talking, we were showing some live aerials of Ferguson on Florissant, what we've learned, and we're finding out that another police car is on fire. Now at least two police cars on fire in Ferguson.
And we also showed you a Walgreens was on fire, and that was another building. We're not quite sure what it is, but clearly a very big fire starting there. And ABC 17's Jillian Fertig is live outside of Second Baptist Church. It's in Columbia where marchers gathered following the announcement. And Jillian, this was a much different scene than what we're seeing in Ferguson tonight.
Oh, absolutely, Marissa. It's pretty much quiet here, actually. They stayed a little bit after that decision was made. They talked and they planned a march for tomorrow. But as of right now, it's pretty quiet. The lights have been turned off here at the church. I did catch up with some of them afterwards tonight. They tell me they are planning a march for tomorrow. I talked with the president of the NAACP chapter here in Columbia. She tells me they're planning local marches here in Columbia as well as in Jefferson City. She tells me her biggest concern is for the children out there tonight. She encourages peaceful protesting. That's what they're going to do tomorrow. Take a listen to what she had to say.
These kinds of things that we cannot afford for these kinds of things to continue, and that we will have to do whatever it is we have to do to mobilize our people to make the impact that we need to make.
Again, the NAACP will be out here again tomorrow, along with other groups in the community. They're planning on marching starting at 5:30. They'll begin here at the church. They'll march down Broadway and to the Boone County Courthouse. Reporting live in Columbia tonight, Jillian Fertig, ABC 17 News.
Jillian, thank you. And it's certainly good to see that protesters in mid-Missouri, at least, are keeping it calm and peaceful, at least so far.
Yeah, and speaking of that, the NAACP and coalition partners announced they're going to be putting together a march from Ferguson to Jefferson City as well. And
seeing now is obviously a building fire, and we're told it may be a pizza restaurant that has been set ablaze, possibly by the protesters there. It looks like it is a Little Caesar's
pizza.
Yeah, you
can see on the bottom corner of the screen. It's tough to see now, but it does say Little Caesar's there on the side. Wow.
That in addition to the two cars that are on fire, at least two that we know of. We saw protesters earlier rocking a car, looking like they were going to overturn the vehicle.
Mm-hmm. And we've been hearing a lot of different reports from the St. Louis County Police Department that people have been throwing Molotov cocktails at them, as well as rocks and bottles. The police also say that a police car back windshield was shattered. Actually, we did see a photo from the St. Louis County Police Department's Twitter feed of a protester that was hit in the face with concrete. And also, we're hearing a lot more reports of looting, for example, at the Family Dollar on West Florissant, and more looting in that whole area.
Armored vehicles, gas masks are out, riot gear, the full complement when you see a situation like this. Some reporters on the scene were told that, well, they had to go away for a little while because they weren't prepared for the gas. They didn't bring gas masks, which another sign of the times for our craft. And this is, again, the Little Caesars on Florissant there in Ferguson.
Well, we do have a chilly night out there. We do have clear skies, though, as the clearing has moved in. In fact, that's cooling our temperatures rather quickly. Storm tracker Kristen Finders in Boonville checked in with me. She says it's still 33 with clear skies, and 34 right now at Fulton to 33 at Jefferson City. So getting cool out there tonight, and those temperatures will be cold as you head out the door in the morning. Temperatures starting in the low 20s, reaching the upper 30s to near 40 in the afternoon. The difference tomorrow, much more sunshine. and lighter winds than we had today, although the temperatures will make it very similar to what we had today, into the upper 30s to near 40 tomorrow. Lows tonight dropping to the lower to mid 20s. A cold start to the day in the morning at 23 in Columbia, 26 at the Lake of the Ozarks, Boonville at 24 tonight, Montgomery City at 24. And then tomorrow we make it to the upper 30s to near 40 degrees. A chilly day, but nothing that's going to be too unusual for November, as we hit 41 at Warsaw, at 42 at the lake tomorrow. Fulton, you'll hit 39 for the high of the day. So kind of cold out there at Moberly as well at 38. Columbia and Jefferson City touching at 40 with a light west-southwest wind. Clearing skies are occurring right now on the backside of that storm system that brought our rain last night. Now we can look forward to some sun tomorrow before the clouds move back in tomorrow night. And that's with this storm system that's going to bring a chance of snow tomorrow night and early Wednesday. In fact, here are the details on that. It looks like that snow will move in from late Tuesday night through mid-morning Wednesday, anywhere from 4 to 9 in the morning. And we could see some minor accumulation from that. I'll have an hourly track coming up in my next full forecast in 10 minutes. I'll show you the latest future track of that, the snow that moves in Wednesday morning. It doesn't last long, and it does melt as temperatures go above freezing. It's colder and dry for Thanksgiving. And then as we head into the weekend, look at that, another mild weekend ahead.
Thank you, Sharon. We are continuing our coverage of Ferguson now. After the grand jury, of course, refused to indict Ferguson police officer Darren Wilson in this case. Didn't find the evidence to do
no so. Justice, no peace.
And we'll also bring you local reactions to the decision. That's coming up next.
ABC 17 Storm Track Weather can be heard on Zimmer radio stations, 94.3 Cat Country and News Radio 950 KWOS.
If you're going to have surgery, what kind of surgeon would you rather have? The surgeon who acts like a human being and treats you like one? Or the master of this thing for robotic surgeries? He'll get the job done. So, will it be the surgeon who brings you a newspaper on his day off? Or the one who performs the most hip, knee, spine, and open heart procedures around? Why do you have to choose? At Boone, you don't. Your community knows Boone for being highly compassionate, but the medical community knows us for being highly skilled. It's just another reason to choose Boone.
The Toyota Black Friday sales event is back. This week only, lease a new 2014 Avalon XLE with zero due at signing, zero first month's payment, zero deposit, and zero down. Or, if you prefer, get 0% APR for 60 months plus $1,000 bonus cash on a 2014 Avalon. The Toyota Black Friday sales event ends December 1st, so hurry into your local Toyota dealer today or learn more at buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Tonight, Jennifer Aniston's secret is out.
I didn't know if you wanted me to mention that.
Come on, someone must have tasted breast milk in the dark.
And Ken Jeong nails it.
Boom.
Plus, Guillermo back-to-back at the AMAs. New Jimmy Kimmel Live tonight on ABC.
From safety to fuel economy to standard features, a Chevy Cruze has it all. The only compact sedan with a 5-year, 100,000-mile warranty. Roadside assistance and courtesy transportation, plus a 2-year, 24,000-mile maintenance package, all standard. During the Chevy Black Friday sale, get a Chevy Cruze for as low as $159 a month or $2,500 total cash allowance. See your Heart of Missouri Chevy dealer today.
It's coming.
It's huge.
Yes.
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 You ask, Moex delivers. Expanded schedule. 20 daily round trips. I'm cool. 3 a.m. departure to St. Louis. 11:30 p.m. St. Louis return. 10:30 p.m. from KC. Door-to-door service.
We want you to ride Moex.
All right, you're looking at a live shot here, an aerial view of what was a Little Caesars pizza restaurant and store there in Ferguson on Florissant, I believe. And looks like it's obviously fully engulfed there and complete loss.
Yeah, that fire just quickly became out of control. And we also have a live look of Interstate 44. It's actually closed in both directions at Grand. This is video here from the Missouri Department of Transportation's website.
You can find that website on ours as well at abc17news.com if you wanted to track a little bit more of that.
No justice, no peace. No crooked police. No justice, no peace. No crooked police.
And those were some of the chants of protesters here in mid-Missouri.
ABC 17's Dana Clemens spent the night with the University of Missouri students, some of the evening, who launched their own rally in Columbia after the decision. And Dana, how'd they react?
Joey, students were outraged at the decision, some crying, some screaming, many holding signs like this, saying, "Speak out, our lives matter." Around 20 to 30 students gathered at the speaker circle to wait for the decision. And although they were lacking in numbers, they made up for it in passion. Some of the students I talked to said they skipped going home when Thanksgiving break started just so they could be here for the decision and the rally. After giving Michael Brown 4.5 minutes of silence after the decision, like his family asked for, they yelled chants and discussed what the decision meant to them as they marched across campus to downtown Columbia.
That's what we're fighting over. We're arguing over skin. Skin, because skin is a thing.
Hands up, don't shoot.
Hands up,
don't shoot.
Hey, hey, ho, ho. These killer cops stand there to go.
We're young, we're strong, we're marching all night long.
They marched across campus to peacefully protest at the Boone County Courthouse.
Dana, thank you. And Dan Messinio was also live in Jefferson City tonight. He spent the day speaking with local church leaders who were preparing for tonight's decision.
He joins us live at Joshua House. And Dan, this was also a peaceful event.
Joey, it was. It was peaceful and an emotional night here at the Joshua House in Jefferson City after the grand jury's decision. Now, right after the decision, religious leaders took the stage, all of them praying for peace and for a better future in here in mid-Missouri and in Ferguson. Now, the community here waited nervously to hear the grand jury's decision. They had their computers out streaming it. They were looking on their cell phones. They were checking social media. When the decision came down, there were audible gasps in the room. People were shaking their heads. I talked to a church parishioner, and she told me that the shooting of Brown was inhumane. She said she's discouraged and devastated, but she said there is hope for the future. She said that the community needs to come together, especially on a night like tonight, and love one another. Reporting live in Jefferson City, Dan Messinio, ABC 17 News. Okay, Dan, thank you.
We're continuing to track this live coverage of Ferguson and the aftermath of the grand jury's decision. And Sharon will have a forecast for you coming up next.